with 16mm, and today we are doing another comparison video, so let us just jump right into it. Well, at this point you're probably wondering if I've gone mad. Well, it's safe to say that I was never sane to compare these two lenses to each other, but alas, here we are. In this video we are comparing the brand new Sigma DCDN 16mm 1.4 and the well-regarded, most times hated kit lens for the Sony NEX systems. So that's the SCLP-Z16-50 3.5-5.6. Now, comparing these two lenses to many wouldn't make sense, but I did it anyways. First thing we notice is the size. The Sony kit lens is much smaller than the Sigma, but when extended out, it's almost right below the length of the Sigma, so it's almost the same size. The positive is that the Sony lens collapses once the camera is off, which is a good thing if you are looking for portability. So let us just get down into the details, and if we want to break down the pros and cons of both lenses, we will have, starting with the pros, for the Sigma, we have amazing image quality, especially wide open, 1.4 f-stop, great auto and manual focus. For the Sony, we have a lot of pros, and that is optical stabilization. It is smaller and lighter, very, very smaller and lighter than the Sigma. Amazing auto and manual focus. Now keep in mind that this is the kit lens to the Sony NEX system, so it's going to be optimized for the APS-C sensor that Sony puts out for every single camera, starting from the NEX-3 all the way up to the Sony A6500. That is why they are still using this very same exact model on all of their NEX systems, except for the Alpha 7s. And silent focus motor. This lens is completely silent when it comes to focusing, and with the internal microphone to the Sony A6000, you don't hear a thing when it's focusing. Now, passing on to the cons of both lenses, we will start with the Sigma, and the first con is that it is very big and heavy, and of course, coming in at almost 450 grams, it is really no slouch, and it just unbalances on the A6000. The focus motor makes a bit of noise that can be heard in video when using the internal microphones. And of course, the biggest thing that really made me hate this lens was that there is no optical stabilization. Now what does that mean? That means that the kit lens, for example, has optical stabilization and does a very, very good job. And there is no need to stabilize the video in post-production, which means that we don't lose any quality, or we don't have a cropped image, which a lot of times happens whenever you crop the video in post-production. So the kit lens has a major advantage over the 16mm Sigma regarding this. Now regarding the Sony, the first big con is the 3.5 f-stop from 16mm. Of course, from 16mm, because as you go into the go up to 50mm, it goes to 5.6, which is a little bit ridiculous for 50mm, as you have many 50mm lenses that are 1.4 to 1.8 to 2.2, etc., etc. So I think Sony really could have done better with this, and I honestly think that it's probably time to update their arsenal. Icon on the kit lens is heavy vignetting and distortion. Now this can be easily corrected in post-production, but keep in mind that the vignetting on the sides, actually when you correct it, doesn't mean that the picture gets actually sharper or better in terms of image quality. It just means you remove the black vignetting and you still have very bright, visible, bad quality in the image. And that brings it to the next con, which is the image quality, which is decent for pictures, but horrible in the corners. And as we've seen with previous video comparisons, that the kit lens actually has very, very bad quality in the extreme corners, from wide open 3.5. Of course, when you go up to 5.6, it gets a little bit better, but it is really nothing to write home about. So that is the main breakdown for the pros and the cons, but let's get into the image quality to see an actual comparison between the two lenses. And we can clearly see there is a huge difference between the two. Now the first thing we notice is that on the right side there is a lot of distortion on the kit lens with a lot of heavy vignetting in the very far corners. One thing that actually does pop to mind is that you can clearly see that because of the vignetting here, you can see the building back here and the Ferris wheel, whereas here you can't because it's very bright. Because generally on the Sigma, there is less distortion with respect to the kit lens, and because there is less distortion, the image looks like it's zoomed in a little bit more. But that's really not the case. They're both 16 millimeters, but the distortion on the kit lens makes it seem like it could be less. There are both lenses at 3.5. Of course, the kit lens can't go any more than that. But as you can see here, the kit lens actually doesn't do that much of a bad job in the corners. I mean, the Sigma is really sharp, as you can see here. That's really, really sharp. Now, coming over to the very corners here, in as far as picture quality is concerned, unfortunately, I'm sorry for the kit lens, but there is a huge difference here, because the car that is right there, that is parked there, you can see that it is much more defined in the Sigma lens than in the kit lens. And it's no competition. And even if you get rid of this heavy vignetting that is in the corners of the kit lens, you still would have very bad picture quality, as you can see here. Now as for video mode, I'll be honest, I've had more fun with the kit lens than with the Sigma because of the stabilization, as I mentioned before. With the Sigma, as I mentioned already, I had to add stabilization in post, which again reduces quality of the video and it crops in the video a bit. So a lot of times I actually messed up the frame I was aiming for because it has to crop in a little bit to be able to stabilize the picture. But none of this actually happens when you have a built-in stabilizer in the lens. It is stabilized from 16 millimeters and there is no cropping involved. And again, also keep in mind that the autofocus in the kit lens is dead silent, while in the Sigma, it has an audible buzz. So this is also very important when recording video. So considering all the points above, which lens would I actually choose out of the two? Well, it's pretty much a head-to-head match at this point, and I would definitely select the Sigma for the best possible image quality and 1.4 for those low light situations. But for video, I would select, and here we go, the kit lens, and I'm gonna get a lot of hate for this, but I select the kit lens as it gave me the best possible results for video with the built-in optical stabilization, which did not require me to crop in or lose further image quality. Now I know its low light capabilities are not great, but for video, you still set the shutter speed to 1/50th of a second, which brightens up the image, and it actually compensates a lot for the loss of f-stops that you get by using the kit lens instead of the Sigma.